brackets and absolute value. So one thing that you should be aware of, there are basically four different types of brackets when you utilize math. And these brackets are the following. So we have brace brackets. So this is the left brace bracket. This is the right brace bracket. And now, what is this brace bracket used for? So we never use these brackets in computations. So in regular expressions, when we calculate, so when you start doing additions, subtractions, multiplications, divisions, or exponents, and so on. So these particular brackets are actually only used to create sets for us. So sets is some collection of items. So for example, you might say that the natural numbers, which is the set of all counting numbers, and you would open your bracket and to tell the reader, you know, what you want to put inside of this set. So natural numbers are just counting numbers. They go on forever, and then you would close the set in this way. So that's one example of using these types of brackets. Now, the next set of brackets, so this one is probably the most common. It's just a round bracket, so the left and the right. And this is indeed used within computation, or just regular arithmetic. So if you're going to do additions and subtractions and so on, so for instance, if you have 2 plus, let's say, open bracket, so 3 times 2 minus 1, and you wanted to close the bracket. So in this case, these brackets right here just designate that you have this factor which you want to isolate, okay, and do the computation within. So those are the round brackets. Now, another set of brackets which are also used in arithmetic are the square brackets, which are these ones. And you can use these interchangeably. And typically we use it because it's a little bit easier to see. If you are consistently using these square brackets as we did here, and you have many of them within an expression, then it starts to slowly get harder on the eyes to try to distinguish between brackets. So for instance, you know, if we take the same expression as we have above, okay, so I have, say, something like this. Now, I could, you know, you can now start using square brackets, because let's say we made this bigger. Okay, so something like this. And now it is a little bit easier to see. So these are your round brackets, and then you have your square brackets right here. So both of these are used within arithmetic. And now the last bracket, which not most students are accustomed to, okay, and these are just kind of straight lines. So this is called the absolute value of whatever is inside of that bracket. Okay, so it is really looking for the magnitude of the number. So I'll illustrate this through examples just so that you know what we mean. So when we have the straight lines and we're looking for the absolute, so for instance, you know, if I ask you, okay, so the absolute value of negative 5, which is inside of that bracket, the answer is actually 5. Because what these brackets do, they are only interested in the magnitude of the number. So they don't care if it's positive or negative. It is just how big is this in terms of the magnitude. So whenever you see these brackets, you know, there's, you know, you can do many examples. Let's say negative 21. So the answer would be just 21. Okay, so those absolute values, just take out the magnitude. Now, if the number is actually, let's say, positive inside, then it just simply stays positive. So really the only impact that you see is, okay, if your answer inside is negative, okay, so then it changes. And you can use them even within expressions. So for instance, you can have something like this. Let's say negative 2, you know, plus 7, say times 2. Okay, so minus, let's say, 20. Okay, and all of that is in absolute brackets. So let me just compute this for us. So you would first have to find, okay, everything within the bracket. So my answer, so let's say negative 2 plus now 7 times 2. So that's 14. Okay, and then minus 20. And now if I compute that, so negative 2 plus 14. Okay, so that's plus 12. And 12 minus 20 is negative 8. But because we put, okay, so notice we had this all in absolute values always. So then your answer would actually be 8. So that's what this bracket designates. Okay, so whenever you run into it, okay, so this is called the absolute value of the number inside, and it just takes away the magnitude itself. Okay, now the last one is something you can think of. If the number is 0, then of course, so the magnitude just stays 0. So really the only impact is right here, okay, whenever you have negatives. Okay, so it just takes the positive. Okay, thank you for watching.